How to Create an Online Asynchronous Module by Ting Su at SF State Program and Visual Impairments, https://viprogram.sfsu.edu. In each iLearn block, I'll put the week number, the topic for that week, and also the date. So again, that clarity of what students can expect for each week has to be, you can just put that in there. So there's no confusion. So for each iLearn block, I usually do a bullet of just, you know, what we're gonna cover that day. So this week in particular, I designed it to be asynchronous. I have these labels where each section label, I'll just click into the edit settings so you can see how I format it so it pops up big like that. And this is also really nice for accessibility too, both with visual accessibility and any students who need to use access technology. But when I type in activities, I can actually highlight it. And then when I click into this paragraph styles, I choose like heading large or heading medium, and that makes it big because I want it to be a big heading. Especially when it's asynchronous, it's very good to be clear about what the expectations are. So I always have it highlighted, like what if things are due. I also have the expectation that participation on all forums will be counted as class attendance. So the things that I want them to do is I want them to view a webcast. I prepared two forums that they have to post and reply to. And sometimes it's just a one-time post, such as this first one, Empowering Students, Building Self-Determination. And I tell them exactly what I want them to do. So post one idea for a strategy or activity that positions your student to help others. And identify the context and the subject of your post. And this seems like a no-brainer, but unless you tell students that, you'll get like, you know, 20 discussion posts that says discussion post. So this way, you know, I want them to be able to also quickly see like, oh, which, like if I'm more interested in one thread or another, or, hey, I remember that this one thread talked about Braille Club, how do I quickly find it? So it does take a little bit of an explanation to help the students develop their own digital literacy. So let me go back to the main iLearn site. Okay, so that other forum was just a one-time post. I wanted them to share an idea. This other post, I want them to actually reply to each other. So it says discussion post due by 4:15, reply to colleagues that are due before next class. So again, it's very important to be clear what you want them to post, when you want them to post, and when you expect replies by. Okay. And this is actually one of their main assignments, which is why it's a little bit more of involved directions than the other one. So I just have like the breakdown in points for what's expected in this post. And then we have class presentations for this week. And so I've been using Flipgrid for class presentations. And I know some of you might have heard of it already, but Flipgrid is a nice way to kind of offline the class presentations. Otherwise you're like, you know, everybody's bored out of their minds listening to presentations for like two class periods. And so this is an example of what Flipgrid looks like. It gives you up to 5 minutes recording per presentation. So I tell students exactly what I'm expecting in their presentation. Again, this is part of their assignment, so that's why there's points assigned to it. And students get to have a pretty fun time with it. So they record themselves for 5 minutes, and they can comment on each other's presentations here. And it's a pretty fun way to do presentations. This is what it looks like. And you can click on any one of these and then you play the video and it's fun. It's fun. Flipgrid. Close like this. And usually I'll have like readings that are due for the week, and then I'll have reference items. So these are like not required, but it's kind of like FYI or extra resources or, you know, whatever it is you want to give them.
And that's pretty much it for designing an asynchronous module. Just remember, you know, be clear about your expectations. If you want to really check up on whether or not students have viewed the videos or readings that you've assigned, you can definitely build that into the discussion forum and ask them to cite specific parts of the reading or video or ask them to synthesize things. So it's really nice for the students to have multiple ways to demonstrate what they've learned from that week's materials, and also to have an opportunity to put things together, to reflect, and also engage with each other in their own learning. So hope that was helpful to you, and I'll be making more videos. Thanks. Bye.